Hello, this short video is titled The Stranger, A Parable for Our Times, Author Unknown. A few months after I was born, my dad met a stranger who was new to our small town. From the beginning, Dad was fascinated with this enchanting newcomer and soon invited him to live with our family. The stranger was quickly accepted and was welcomed quite easily around town. As I grew up, I never questioned his place in our family. Mom taught me the stories and truths of the Bible, and Dad told me stories about following God. But the stranger was a storyteller, too. He could weave the most fascinating tales. Adventures, mysteries, and comedies were daily conversations. He could hold our whole family spellbound for hours each evening. He was like a friend to the whole family. He took Dad Bill and me to our first Major League Baseball game, and he was always encouraging us to see the movies, and even made arrangements to introduce us to several movie stars. The stranger was an incessant talker. Dad didn't seem to mind, though, but sometimes Mom would quietly get up, while the rest of us were enthralled with one of his stories of faraway places, leave the room and go to her bedroom, maybe to read a book or the Bible, and to probably pray. I wonder now if she ever prayed that the stranger would leave. You see, my dad helped cultivate the moral convictions of our family. But this stranger never felt an obligation to honor them. Profanity, for example, was not allowed in our house, not from us, from our friends, or adults. But our longtime visitor used occasional four-letter words that burned my ears and made Dad squirm. To my knowledge, the stranger was never confronted. My dad was not a drinker either. But the stranger felt like we needed exposure and enlightened us to other ways of life. He offered us beer and other alcoholic beverages often. He made cigarettes look tasty and cigars manly and pipes distinguished. He talked freely, I think too freely, about sex. His comments were sometimes blatant, sometimes suggestive, and always pretty embarrassing. I know now that my early concepts of the man-woman relationship were wrongly influenced by the stranger. As I look back, I believe it was the grace of God that the stranger did not influence us even more. I really think Mother was praying for us, as time after time he opposed the values of my parents, yet was seldom rebuked and never asked to leave. More than 30 years have passed since the stranger moved in with our family on Morningside Drive, but if I were to walk into my parents' living room today, you would still see him sitting over in a corner, waiting for someone to listen to him talk and watch him draw his pictures. His name? We always just called him TV. This is a parable for our times and might cause you to ponder these following questions. What has TV told you to believe about the world? How has TV shaped your values? What do you do when TV says things or shows you things that you know are bad for you or you disagree with? What influence have you allowed TV to have on your children? How much time do you spend with TV compared to other friends? What would society be like if everyone spent less time with TV? Is there anything you might change in your relationship with TV? Please ponder these questions as an individual with your family and with friends and make society a better place and our society function more properly and healthfully. This is U.S. Civics Training. Thanks for listening.